Good luck, Grandpa.
Good luck.
Yeah, pre-concert activity. You paid? You ready for the concert?
Yes.
I think we're all ready.
Represent areas of his life.
Get a shot of the crowd. He's hearing his mom out in the back. They're still filing in.
Let's walk around.
Okay, you're gonna have to be a little quieter, Callan. Where's his pacifier?
Where's the bag?
That's right here. I need a little more light. I got my low light things on. Oh, the sound's a lot better now. I guess it's low light. Mm-hmm. I got like low light.
Well, if they take down the overhead lights, it might be hard. I took my camera off of autofocus, but it.
You set it.
Yeah, I zoomed in on you when you were standing there, and it took it off autofocus. It was staying.
It is good. Oh, you can say good evening back. That's fine.
Good evening back.
Good evening back. Okay. Let's stand tonight and have a word of prayer before we begin this concert.
Our Lord and our God, what a joy it is to welcome everyone to this place. Lord, we thank you for Bob and the gifts that you have given him. And Lord, tonight, he gives this concert to your glory. We ask, Lord, that your Holy Spirit would meet us here at this place. We pray that through song, through the time of fellowship, Lord, that we would sense your Spirit ministering to us. As we quiet our hearts before you tonight, we pray, O Lord, that we can be part of the witness throng that notices the coming of you to this place. For we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. As you're seated tonight, would you put your hands together and welcome Bob here. Bob Brooks.
Something good is going to happen to you this very day. This very hour, something good is going to happen to you. Jesus of Nazareth is passing your way. As I walk through the door, I felt his presence. And I knew this was the place where love abounds. For this is the temple Jehovah God abides in. We are standing in his presence on holy ground. We are standing on holy ground. And I know that there are angels all around. Let us pray. Now standing in His presence on holy ground. In this very room, there's quite enough love for all of us. In this very room, there's quite enough joy for all of us. And there's quite enough hope and quite enough power to chase the gloom all away. For Jesus, Lord Jesus, is in this very
thank you. Appreciate y'all coming tonight. As you can see from that opening segment, we're in the presence of God and His presence. For He has said, where two or three are gathered in My name, I will be there. And so He's here, and you're here, and we're here to have a good time. Some of you have come maybe to support me. Some of you have come to support the fact that Habitat is involved. Some of you have come maybe to be entertained. But the purpose tonight is for you to worship. A little higher emotion than to be entertained. In any case, we're extremely glad you're here tonight. I'm going to take you on a little journey, answer a few questions. This journey is kind of a journey through my life, and it started with a song. When I was 4 years old, across the street from our house in New York, an immigrant family was building a house. I believe they were from one of the Slovak countries. And as they were building this house, they were working on the roof, as I recall. 4-year-old doesn't recall too much. But they were on the roof, and they were singing, God Bless America. And ever since that time, I've been singing. It just really impressed me. This next song answers the question why I'm still singing. Okay, Tom?
Of music, I just can't help it. God gave the song. Come on along, it's the song of Jesus. Day after day, that song goes on. Found the source of music. I just can't help it. God gave the song. For I have found the song. Day after day, that song goes on, for I have found the source of music. I just just can't help it. God gave the song, for I have found the source of music. I just can't help it. God gave the song. God gave the song. God gave the song.
God gave the song. He forgot to give me the words. That's the only problem. I know almost all of you folks, but some of you only know me in one type of setting. And because of that, I've got a bunch of hats up here. I'm kind of a guy that likes hats. And some of you probably know me as a golfer. Some of you know me as a softball player. Some of you know me as a basketball player. Some of you know me as a senior Olympian. Some of you know me as a kayaker. Some of you know me as an elk tone. Some of you know me as a bowler. Some of you know me as a teacher and a driver ed instructor. Some of you know me as a coach. Some of you know me as a habitatter. Some of you know me as a board member at Hambuco Credit Union. Some of you know me as a missionary of sorts and a world traveler and a sports fan. And then I'm also a husband, a dad, a grandpa, and a friend. And I'm all of those things, of course. But there's one hat I'd like to wear and be recognized as a Christian. This is my ultimate desire in life. Some of you, because of the fact that you only know me in one setting, do not know my family. So I'd like to take just a minute to introduce my family. Best family ever was. This is my wife, Bonnie, over here. Stand up, please. And my daughter, Robin, and her husband, Scott. And my grandson, Sam, and back here, my granddaughter, Bailey. My youngest son, Brett, his wife, Kelly, and their daughter, Paige. And my in-between son, Scott, and his wife, Coco, and our newest grandson, Callan. And we got news tonight that Miss Kelly is expecting. So sometime in April, we're going to grow as a family. That's my family. Give them a hand, please. This next little segment is kind of answering the question, who I am, what I am, and how I came to be.
And all the joy
floods my soul. Something happened, and now I know he touched me and made me whole. Something beautiful, something good. All my confusion, he understood. Child of the King, His royal blood now flows in my veins, and I, who was wretched and poor, now I can sing, praise God, praise God, I'm a child of the King. Well, it's a wonderful feeling when you know you found what you've been looking for. No more trouble, no more looking around to find something worth living for. I found Jesus, and there's no doubt about it, He's everything I wanted and more. And it's a wonderful feeling when you know you found what you've been looking for. Jesus, 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 there's just something about that name. Master, Savior, Jesus, like the fragrance after a rain. Jesus, 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 let all heaven something about that name.
This next little segment will answer the question where I've been and where I am now.
Twas a life filled with aimless desperation. Without hope, walked the shell of a man. Stretch downward, just one touch and a new life began. And the old rugged cross made the difference in a life bound for heartache and defeat. I will praise Him forever. Made the difference for me. I want Jesus in my life more than anything this world can offer me. All I know that He alone can satisfy. Just one breath to leading in my life is worth everything that I might sacrifice. Oh, I want Jesus more than anything. Take the fame that I might want and all the things that seem so dear. I'd rather have Him than any praise that men may give to me. I want Him to have control and be the breath of life in me. I'd rather have Jesus, I'd rather have Him than anything. As I go on through life with Him, there can be no other way. I want Jesus more than Jesus. I wouldn't trade my King. What He gave to me will last eternally. What I have never fades. I wouldn't trade. Finally,
in this segment, before we take a break, let me sing three songs. The first one tells what I hope to do, and the next two, how I feel.
If I can help somebody as I pass along, if I can cheer somebody with a word or song, if I can show somebody he is traveling wrong, then my living has not been in somebody as I pass along, then my living has has not been in vain. If I can do my duty as a Christian ought, if I can bring back beauty to a world abroad, if I can spread love's message as the Master taught, then my living has not been in vain. Then my living has not been in vain. Then my living has not been in vain. If I can help somebody as I pass along, then my living has not been in vain. O'er me sweep, when the waters are too deep, through the road is rough and steep, he'll see me through. Oh, thank God of this I'm sure, with his help I shall endure, for his promise is secure, his word is true. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any creature can separate me from the love of God. How can I say thanks for the things he has done for me? Things so undeserved, yet he gave to prove his love for me. The voices of a million angels could not express my gratitude. All that I am or ever hope to be, I owe it all to thee. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. To God be the glory for the things he has done. With his blood he has saved me. With his power he has raised me. To God be the glory for the things he has done. Lord, let me live. be. And should I gain any praise, let it go to Calvary. With his blood he has saved me, with his power he has raised me. To God be the glory for the things he has done.
I want to thank you again for coming. I hope you've had a chance to worship and be blessed. When the Lord first spoke to me about doing this, I had to keep saying, you know, how am I going to do this? What do you want me to do? And that kind of thing. And he said, well, be sure to tell them about yourself. I tried to do that. Tell them about Habitat. And Hager's done that. He said, but most of all, tell them about me. And so in this second half here, I will attempt to do that. There's two songs that best represent two aspects of Jesus' life that we're most familiar with, and that's his birth and his death.
Sweet little Jesus boy, they made you be born in a manger. Sweet little holy child, didn't know who you was, didn't know you come to save us, Lord, to take our sins away. Our eyes was blind, we couldn't see. We didn't know who you was. Long time ago, you was born in a manger low, sweet little Jesus boy. The world treats you mean, Lord, treats me mean too, but that's how things is down here. We don't know who you is. You done told us how we is a trying master. You done showed us how, even when you's dying, just seems like we can't do right. Look how we treated you, but please, sir, forgive us, Lord. We didn't know 'twas you. Sweet little Jesus boy, born
in Jerusalem that day. The soldiers tried to clear their narrow street, but the crowd pressed in to see the man condemned to die on Calvary. He was bleeding from a beating. There were stripes upon his back, and he wore a crown of thorns upon his head. And he bore with every step the scorn of those who cried out for his death. Down the Via Dolorosa, called the Way of Suffering, like a lamb came the Messiah, Christ the King. But he chose to walk that road out of his love for you and me. Down the Via Dolorosa, all the way to Calvary. Por la Via Dolorosa, Trieste in Jerusalem, los soldados la abrien paso a Jesús. Mas la gente se acercaba para ver aquella baba, aquella cruz. Por la Via Dolorosa, que es la Via del Dolor, como vio vino Cristo, Rey Señor. Y fue quien quiso ir por su amor, por ti, por mí. Por la Via Dolorosa, a Calvario y a morir. The blood that would cleanse the souls of all men made its way through the heart of Jerusalem. Down the Via Dolorosa, called the Way of Suffering, like a lamb came the Messiah, Christ the King. But he chose to walk that road out of his love for you and me. Down the Via Dolorosa, all the way to Calvary. Stole a theme for tonight from a little book that I got about 20 years ago. It's written by Bob Benson Jr. and it's called "Come Share the Being." And he writes in the book some things I'd like to share with you. He says, he was a Sunday school teacher in a Baptist church down in Tennessee. In the last few months in our college Sunday school class, we have been studying a passage, or mostly a phrase from 2 Peter, in the New English Bible is translated like this: "And through these promises, great beyond all price, you may come to share in the very being of God." And together we have been trying to define the very being of God. In the King James, it speaks of being made partakers of the nature of God. But somehow it seems stronger to me to think of what we might be if we shared in the very being of God. And then later on in the book, he says, the American Heritage Dictionary of the English language defines part of the meaning of share as follows: to share, to participate in, to use, or experience in common, to have, or take a part. All of a sudden, it dawned on me what God was saying to me. Why don't you take what you have and what you are, your being, and I will take what I have and what I am, my being, and we will share. We will participate in, we will use, we will experience together in common. And I began to see that a fantastic as I am, witty, knowledgeable, leader of men, talented, as great as I am, when I put what I had with what I am and hope to be with what he is, and all of a sudden, I had stumbled on a bargain of a lifetime. I was getting the long end of the stick. You remember when they had old-fashioned Sunday school picnics? It was before air conditioning. They said, we'll meet at the Sycamore Lodge in Shelby Park at 4:30 Saturday. You bring your supper and we'll furnish the tea. But you came home at the last minute, and when you got ready to pack your lunch, all you could find in the refrigerator was one dried up piece of bologna and just enough mustard in the bottom of the jar so you got it all over your knuckles trying to get it. And there were just two stale pieces of bread, so you made your bologna sandwich and wrapped it in some brown bag and went to the picnic. And when it came time to eat, you sat at the end of the table and spread out your sandwich. But the folks next to you, the lady was a good cook, and she had worked all day. And she had fried chicken, baked beans and potato salad, homemade rolls and sliced tomatoes, and pickles and olives and celery, and topped it off with two big homemade chocolate pies. And they spread it all out beside you, and there you were with your bologna sandwich. But they said to you, why don't we put it all together? No, I couldn't do that. I just couldn't even think of it, you murmured embarrassingly. Oh, come on, there's plenty of chicken and plenty of pie and plenty of everything, and we just love bologna sandwiches. Let's just put it all together. And so you did, and there you sat, eating like a king when you came as a pauper. And I get to thinking. I think of me sharing with God. And when I think of how little I bring and how much he brings and that he invites me to share, I know I should be shouting from the housetops, but I am so filled with awe and wonder that I can hardly be heard. I know you don't have a love or faith or grace or mercy or wisdom. There's just not enough of you. But he has. He has all those things in abundance and says, let's just put it all together. Consecration, denial, sacrifice, commitment, crosses, these were the kind of the hard, flinty words to me until I saw it in the light of sharing. Not just me kicking in what I have because God is the biggest kid in the neighborhood and wants it all for himself, but he is speaking to me and saying, everything that I possess is available to you. Everything that I am and can be to a person, I will be to you. When I think about it like that, it really amuses me to see somebody running around all through life hanging on to their dumb bag with that stale bologna sandwich in it and saying, God's not going to get my sandwich. No siree, this is mine. Did you ever see anybody like that? So needy, just about half starved to death, hanging on for dear life. It's not that he needs your sandwich. The fact is, you need his chicken. I appreciate y'all coming. But in a group like this, this big, some of you are hurting. Some of you are searching, and some of you are lugging around a stale bologna sandwich. I'd like to listen to a special song. The song's written by Emery Blades, my good friend over here. Wave, Emery. I'd like you to listen to this song and see if there's anything in it that speaks to you.
All sin. And when you lean upon his lasting promises, he'll bring overflowing joy and peace within. He's reaching out his hand, he cares and understands. He wants to touch your heart this very day. If you go to him in prayer, lead your load of burdens there. He will lead you as you journey on your way. It was his grace that saved me from the darkness. His goodness and his mercy light my way. And so, my friend, if you will trust the Savior, he'll bring joy beyond expression day by day. He's reaching out his hand, he cares and understands. He wants to touch your heart this very day. If you'll go to him in prayer, leave your load of burdens there. He will lead you as you journey on your way. He will lead you as you journey on your way.
This past week, we witnessed a young teenage girl affiliated with our congregation become involved in a car accident on Interstate 35, and she and her boyfriend were both killed. We saw this weekend one of the men that we love so dearly and deeply, Reverend Ralph Richardson, who pastored at this church for a number of years, go home this weekend to be with Jesus. We see in both of these instances that of an 80-some-year-old man and that of a young teenage girl, the hand of Jesus reaching out. And in the midst of crises, in the midst of grief, ministering to their families, but more than that, making a provision for a Christian young lady, for a godly man, to go home to glory. This life we live on this earth is but a short time. And it is for the privilege and opportunity of the gospel being presented to you as it was this evening, and for you and I to make the free choice whether we're willing to receive and yield our lives to the Lordship of Jesus Christ, whether we will make Christ our Savior, the one to save us from our sins, and our Lord, one who has control over our lives. I believe it is no accident that you are here, but it is by divine appointment. And whether there be difficulty in your life tonight of some sort or another, whether it be that you have yet to trust in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, we have a tradition in this church, that of an open altar. We have a prayer room to my right, to your left. And if you this evening would like to avail yourself of the presence of Jesus Christ reaching out, his arm is not too short. Whether it is that of saving your soul tonight, and of you knowing and having the assurance that if you were to close your eyes tonight and wake up in judgment tomorrow, you would be in the presence of God, whether it be your personal salvation, or whether it be some great need that you and your family, or you personally have in your life, Jesus is here. And he is willing to meet that need.